Well, Amsterdam Kram, as it was in France, is still one of my favorite books. And I think it's a very popular book still in France because it launched the D.I. Helen Grace character. And when I look back on it now, I think there were things that I might do differently. It's quite a short book and it has a very hard ending. I might soften the ending now a little bit, but you know, it still has a special place in my heart because it was a book that pretty much changed my life. Yeah, so Helen Grace is a detective inspector in Southampton, which is on the south coast of England. And she is a sort of magnet for serial killers. They seem to just sort of come into her life, and she spends her whole time chasing them down. She's a very isolated character. She lives alone, she doesn't drink, she doesn't have any relationships. She's sort of 100% committed to the job. But she's also a very strong and powerful woman. She rides a motorbike, she gets into loads of fights, she's quite sort of kick-ass. She's like a sort of female Dark Knight in Southampton. And she just relentlessly hunts down these serial killers. Over the course of the series, she's evolved. She's had relationships, all of which, of course, go bad. And she has a very supportive police team, particularly her deputy, Charlie. And together they make a powerful team. And Helen is one of these people who will never give up, never stop. But she is also a slightly cursed character. So she's always looking for redemption, but it's always just out of reach. Yeah, so when I first went to Penguin, who are my publisher, I pitched them the first 7 books in the series because I wanted to be ambitious. And normally a writer, an author, they write their first novel and they collapse exhausted and have no idea what they want to do next. But I wanted it to be a series, and that's partly because my background is television. And in TV, you don't want one episode, you want CSI or 24 or whatever. So I thought in big numbers, and I knew that Helen had real kind of promise as a character, and I knew that there were lots of serial killers in Southampton who needed to be caught. Well, there's lots of tricks, but I think the most important thing for me, when I'm creating a Helen Grace book, is to try and find a primal fear, like our deepest fear, whether it's being buried underground or kept in the dark or whatever. And I think if you find something that immediately scares but excites the reader, then you have something to work with. And each time I create a Helen novel, I just sit down and think, now what's the worst thing I can think of? What's the most horrible situation I can put somebody in? And that's always the starting point for me. I mean, we chose the title because obviously in Amsterdam Graham or Eeny Meeny, the characters have to make a terrible choice, and it's who lives and who dies. One lives, one dies. And we came up with that title and we really loved it. And it worked so well because it turned out that every country in Europe and the English speaking world have that rhyme, that childhood rhyme. So that was fantastic. It's Ina Mina in German, Ella Mella in Norway, you know, they all have it. So everyone got in, but the fact that it was a child's rhyme made it feel sort of slightly sinister. And I think then we grew from there. And I think the fun thing about serial killers is as a sort of genre of fiction is they're kind of a bit escapist because they're not terribly real. They're quite heightened, quite gothic. And I think it's a natural sort of genre to play these manipulation games between cat and mouse, between often, as in when the cat's away, between the hunter and the hunted, and the way that those positions can turn. So yeah, it's full of dark games, this series.